next presentation by K.P. Umapathy Acharya, Veda and Architecture in a Vishwakarma Family. What an exciting topic. Actually, I am excited to have Stapathy's directly here. We use the word from the horse's mouth, from the Vishwakarma's mouth, I should say. These are all incarnations of Vishwakarma themselves. When I heard of Ganapati Stapathy's demise, I was so depressed. I thought that the whole Vishwakarma level of creation is all gone. But I am happy to see that so many Stapathys have joined our conference. They are going to talk, and one of the most senior Stapathys, Umapathy Acharya ji, has volunteered to present his own personal experience. He runs a Gurukula residential institute for teaching Sthapatya. He is going to share his experience from an anecdotal, a biographical, autobiographical experience from a Vishwakarma family. That is going to be eye-opening for many who do not know how organic the Vedic culture of a Vishwakarma family is. Sir, K.P. Umapathy Acharya ji, please go ahead.
Namaste. Om Namah Shivaya. Sinduram Panchavakram Dasabhujabhayam Pustakam Likidagatkam Gadvangam Bijapuram Amritakalasam Kandiham Akshamalam Trishula Janamudram Asura Sura Guruhum Vishwakarmam Namami. My humble pranams and respects to my ancestors who were built thousands and thousands of temples in Bharatavarsha, not the present political boundary, but our cultural boundary extended up to Iran, up to Cambodia, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. My humble respects and pranams to the great kings, saints and queens who were responsible for the construction of thousands of temples. My respects to Shefaliji and Sri Nagarajji and Mr. Raghavan and senior architect Sashikalaji. The theme is so good and very needful also. I am very much interested with this conference because it is going to open the eyes of academicians as well as that of the people having the Hindutva in their mind. What actually happened to the Vishwakarma tradition, and what about the relationship between the Vishwakarma and the Vedas? Mr. Nagarajan ji explained in brief. Because my community, Vishwakarma community, we are the ancient temple builders since the time of more than 2000 years, 3000 years. We called us the Stapathy. The Stapathy is the caste surname for the Vishwakarma community and not as your professional name. Nowadays it is most perverted and it is used very loosely. So that I focus my idea towards what my family tradition and what is the connectivity between the Vedas and the Vishwakarmas. Nowadays, very, very few, I do not know how many numbers, having such a tradition. So that I have to, what my experiences and what in my family tradition, I have to focus upon it. I hail from a family of Vedic and Shilpa Shastra scholars and temple architects. So I was fortunate to hear and learn the Veda mantras since my childhood. My father taught me the Vedas and the Silpa Shastra in a very interesting ways and helped me to understand the supremacy of Vedas in every branch of the knowledge system in our country, like Ayurveda system, the astronomical system, etc. While prescribing the qualification of the Vishwakarma, the hereditary architect Stapati, Silpa Shastras emphasize the knowledge of Veda. Mr. Nagaraj in briefly told that why the Western people do not understand it, and they are writing again and again that there is no connectivity between the Vedas and the Vishwakarmas. So it is not at all true. That is all are the academic gimmicks. Since the time of Stella Garabrich and till now, people are again and again repeating certain things, and it is not at all true. They are all us. Meek criticism regarding our Indian traditional knowledge system. While prescribing the qualification of a Vishwakarma, hereditary architect, Silpa Shastra says that Stapati hi Stapanatyaha Vedavit Sarva Shastra Vicharadaha. What it means of Vedavit? Vedavit means knowing the Veda, being conversant with the Veda, knowing the Veda, etc. No, not at all. But the meaning is more profound, and it leads to enter the wonder world of sacred and spiritual architecture. Veda is not the recitation of the Veda again and again. The Vishwakarma community having the unique way to understand the Veda as well as interpreting the Veda. Vishwakarmas having the capability to interpret the Veda in their unique way. Why? Because our temples, even the cave temples, are not mere the temples, they are the expression or the interpretation of the Vedas. That is a visible form of Vedic interpretation. So, Ananda Kumaraswamy says that if we consider such an architectural treatise like Manasara, Ananda Kumaraswamy says that if we consider what Ananda Kumaraswamy says, that if we consider such an architectural treatise such as Manasara, we find in the first place clear evidence of the direct dependence upon the Vedic sources. So, the Stapati, not only the mere knower of the Veda, but he must depend upon the Veda for coming out of lot of things. What it is coming out? That is the inspiration and impulsion. What impulse in the Vedic world, that is issue. As well as it is coming out of the repose also coming. So that the Kumaraswamy very excellently told that we consider such an architectural treatise as a Manasara, we find in the first place the clear evidence of direct dependence. We are not depends upon the Purana. We are not much depends upon the any other text. We are always depends upon the Veda. In my family, my father told again and again, every day we must recite the Veda. Some of the excellent suktas are there. As well as we have the special, as well as a secret prayer. For what? For construction of the temple. I want the clear intuition. I want the perennial institution. It must come in my mind. Because I am very clear that I am not a scholar. I am not an architect. But I am receiving it only from the divine source. It is an inherited idea. That is why we are dependent upon the Vedas. And the direct dependence provider unique experiences to the great architects of yesteryears, assisted in creating and achieving the intended spiritual experiences for the people who will visit for thousands of years to come. Why? Because of Veda. Veda are the root we are constructing the temple. For what purpose? For not for 100 years or the 200 years or the 300 years, but it is for the thousands of years. It has to invite the devotee as well as each and every part of the temple give the message having interaction with that of the human being. That is why the more ancient cultural art of India is embodies in visible form what the Upanishad throws out into a inspired thought. That is by Sri Aurobindo. The sculpture, like architecture, springs from the spiritual realization, and what it creates and expresses at its greatest is the spirit in form. Next page. The soul in the body. The sculpture, like architecture, springs from the soul, spiritual realization. How it is possible? From the yama, niyama, pranayama, pratyagara, dharana, then going for the vikalpa, samadhi. In the samadhi itself, vikalpa, nirvikalpa, samadhi. In the nirvikalpa samadhi, one must know that they self, that is atmanyana, atma darshanam. From the atma darshanam is converted into the temple. The atma darshanam converted into the sculpture in my family tradition. The extended foundation and well-beaten roads which were instituted by my ancestors by emphasizing the Vedas. Vedas has given me foresight to understand and interpret the Shilpa Shastra in the right perception. How to understand the Shilpa Shastra? There were thousands and thousands of Shilpa Shastra in the before the 6th century. The barbarians attacked our temples and demolished for continuously for thousands, hundreds of years. So our Shilpa Shastras were gone. But still it is 30 or the 40 Shilpa Shastras available. What we are calling as the Shilpa Shastra? The Shilpa Shastra is an extended foundation. That is a well-beaten road which were instituted by our ancestors by emphasizing the Veda, have given me the foresight, understand and interact the Shilpa Shastra in right perception. The Shilpa, that is the architecture and the sculpture and painting, is not a profession, it is a tapas. It is a means to attain the moksha. That is the main idea of the Vishwakarma community in all over India. In the Vishwakarma Sutras of the Rig Veda are revered as a source of divine inspiration, direct revelation and vigorous power of creation and expression. What means of the Veda? Vedas having the capability to induce the subconscious, conscious and the supraconscious level of each and every individual. Those want to understand the Veda, just mere repetition and recitation is enough for him to elevate his soul to the such an extent. For Vishwakarma community, two suktas in the 10th mandala of the Rig Veda is most essential, in which that is the perennial source of for us as well as for the illumination of the impulsion. In the second verse of the 10th mandala, 81 sukta and Rig number 2, what was the basis or the primal matter, that is Adhisthana? What was the material, that is Arambana? How was it done? How did the creator of all things, the Vishwakarma, fashion the earth and shape the glory Mahimana of the heavens, beholding all Vishwa, earth Mahimana, that is a heaven beholding all the Vishwa Shakshiku, the mantra reveals the process of creation in the earth. The Vishwakarma Sutta in the 10th mandala is very much essential for each and every Vishwakarma families. In the Veda also mentioned about, Veda also mentioned about the Shilpa. In the family, in my family, still we have certain secret Vedic prayers that Vedic prayer every day we are reciting. Hundreds of time I have to recite that mantras. So, what Veda says about the Shilpa? It says the Acharya Karman, that is act of wonder, Bahuruba, multi-form, Bala, capacity, Chitra Rupa, illuminating form, Karma Kaushala, dexterity of action, Kaushala, dexterity, Samarthya, propensity, Sukshama Karma, subtle act, Yoga, contemplation and concentration of the thought. These terminologies are mentioned about Acharya Karma, Bhagurupa, Bala, Samarthya, Yoga. It is mentioned in the Veda to give explain about the Shilpa. The great Arya Samaj founder, that Dayananda Saraswati, says that what is Shilpa, he explains taking from the Brahmanas. He says that Shilpa Vidya Mahimanam. What is the Shilpa Vidya Mahimanam? If Shilpa Vidya Mahimanam means a Shilpa work that give emphasize that. The Shilpa indicates the science and technology used for the welfare of the human being without any attachment personally. So that is why Shivaliji told so many anonymous architect, there is no signature, etc. That is why it is mentioned without any material, greediness towards material world. Our ancestors have done the work that was mentioned in the Veda. The extensive analysis, please go upwards. Next paragraph. The extensive analysis of the above ancient words, in the Shilpa Sastra, what is the speciality of it? While my father teaching me the Shilpa text, he always insisted this word is ancient. While I am a very young man, young boy, I asked him why it is very ancient. He says that the word coming from the Veda, whatever the words mentioned in the Shilpa Sastra, they have a capability to give the inspiration. That words mostly coming from the Veda. The extensive analysis of the above ancient words facilitate us to understand what Shilpa is and to understand the philosophical and the religious implications. The greatness and continuity of Indian architecture is live in its aim as expressed from the above words. The aim of Indian artist has always been to represent the most essential characteristics of the inner spiritual manifestation of the object. He wishes to represent in art. In the Western world, they are opening their eyes. They are looking the nature, the manifestation of river, brooks, canals, mountains, hilltops, etc. And they put in the canvas or they are carving. But Indian system, Indian panels, Indian sculpture never express, because nature and ourselves are the one and the same. That is why there is no landscape sculpture in our country. The greatness and continuity of the architecture is living its aim as expressed in the above words. The aim of Indian artist has always been to represent the most essential characteristics of the inner spiritual manifestation of the object. But in Indian system, Western system open the eye. But what Indian system says that close your eyes. Vastly, if you are close your eye, you travel inside it. The travel inside it, it is a facilitate, it's a trying, it's understanding of the Atma Darshana. That is a great difference between the two. Closing, open your eyes, it is Western. Close your eye, travel inside. That is the Indian system. According to Aurobindo, the Indian artist aesthetic suggestion is secondary to the spiritual realization. People say, very beautiful, wonderful, beautiful carving. I never bother about it. What about his spiritual idea? Whether he understood the Veda, whether he has the idea about the Vedas and its implications. So, in our country, that is aesthetic suggestion is a very, very secondary than to that of the spiritual realization. Form is but a vehicle to spiritual emotion. It passes not from technique to idea, but technique from idea. It is not the technique to idea. Ellora, best example. Ajanta, this is the best example for it. People say, no cranes, no nothing. But how it was possible? No, no. It is very ordinary mind thing like that. But in our country, the technique is not at all the value. The technique to idea, but technique from the idea giving the techniques to that. According to Indian system, the appeal of the Indian art is not to the eye and to the mind through the eye. No, but to the soul through the eye and the mind. Divya Sakshu, that is the idea. Bhad Bhavan, Paramatma in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, giving the divine eye to the Arjuna. From the Arjuna got the divine eye. He visualized the Vishwarupa of Paramatma. That is why in our system, in the architectural tradition, in Vishwakarma tradition, we are always insisting Divya Sakshu. It is mentioned in the Veda. Divya Sakshu is essential. So, Indian art never been content with the minor realities of the sensation and major reality of the emotion, but has striven to find the supreme reality of the spirit. What Carl Jung says that the collective unconsciousness, is a divine derived by Carl Jung, but it was in practice for the millennium of years in our Indian system. The next is the Silpa Sastras or Upavedas of the Atharva Veda. It is called the Sabhatya Veda. The text on architecture, iconography and painting were written by the rishis who were experienced and codified their process of soul realization by means of Silpa. What is the use of the Silpa? For me, I am an architect, I am a sculptor. Why I am doing this cultural artwork? Not for the fame, not for the money, but I want. It is a means for attaining the moksha. I want to attain the moksha. That is why I am using the architecture and the Silpa, practicing it as a means. That is the idea of my ancestors also. So, in old India, it was ancient India. In ancient India, thousands of Silpa Sastra extensively deal with the range of subjects from town planning, irrigation system, palaces and temples, etc. Now, only a limited number of Sastras, say about 30, are available. Silpa Vidya Ragasya Upanishad, a revered text of Vishwakarma community, says that spirituality is the secret of art. Silpam become a sacrifice. Silpam yajnam bhavatu. Sacrifice means, in the Western concept, the Western world, it is not the suffering, but it is a joyful one. What is sacrifice? That is yajna. What it means? We are inviting the God. Please, you are my master. You are my God. Please take it. At the time, the sacrifice means, yajna means, it is a very clear, very, very extensive joy in our mind. So, the Silpa becomes sacrifice and the philosophical propositions become architecture. There is one question that may arise. How to approach Indian art? The Vishwakarmas adopted a unique system Soul realization is the method of creation, and soul realization must be the way of our response and understanding. For Vishwakarmas, doing architecture is a means to attain the self-realization. In other words, that is the moksha. Now we have to analyze certain important word, that mana, measure. How to measure? Measure is important. Measure everything is important. How to measure? For construction, inch or the centimeter or the nanometer, whatever may be, measurement is very, very essential. We are taking clue from the Veda itself. The fundamental aspect of architecture is measurement, and the Veda Vana is significantly repeated in the Shilpa text. They adopted the conceptual idea, conceptual ideas from the Veda. Shilpa text proclaimed that Vishnu is stated to be the god of both the yardstick and the measuring rod, according to Rig Veda, 1st Mandala, 154 Sukta. Says that Vishnu measured not only the earth, but measured the terrestrial space. Vishnu measured out the terrestrial space and made fast abode on high. That is why we call the Trivikrama mentioned in the Veda. Similarly, the host of Veda mantras hails the act of measuring is secret, and the architects have been doing the same act with the insight gifted by the God. Still, previously, Professor Vinay Kumar says that Vastu Mandala, something I have a different idea. The Vastu Purusha Mandala, it is not mentioned in any text. It is the creation of the Western people. Vastu is there. Mandala is there. Vastu Mandala, but actually it is a Padavinyasa. So, Padavinyasa is a making demarcation of a place for the temple needs a measurement. How it is coming? The act of measuring each and every element of the temple is considered as a direct awareness of infinity, which century after century have been reverently adopted by my ancestors. The measurement, measuring, mana is adopted in the Shilpa text. Brahmiya Chitrakarma Sastra says that sarvam manena nichidam. Manena nichidam sarvam. Everything is measurable. If God is so, he is unmanifested, he is immeasurable. By doing so, he is immeasurable. By the word immeasurable, I measured the God. That was mentioned in the Sadabhava Brahmana. In the Brahmanas, it is Kalpa Sutra and the Silva Sutra, it is mentioned. So,
Namaskar. Actually, I am so hesitant to interrupt your such an ecstatic presentation that I am fully and in goosebumps to hear you. But because we have the whole conference to go on, can you please, as if you are approaching your rewinding, the winding up of your conclusion.
Yes, it is only 30 seconds needed.
Thank you. Sorry, actually, we have to measure time, though.
Yes,
actually, your presentation is so unstoppable. Thank you.
Yes, please. So, it is, I am concluding part only.
Yeah.
So, it is quite natural that several words are arising like that of the mana, measure, mana, pramana, parimana, unmana, upamana, manonmana. All these are thinking of mentioning about the measurement. Those having such a knowledge about the measurement, measured by the God, Trivikrama, he is called as Mana Yogi. And what is this sculpture is called Pratibha. All words have vibrant nature and guide the architects in the rightful way. The word Pratibha is mentioned in the Rig Veda as the likeness of all things. Vishvasya Pratibhanam. The Shilpa text indicating the meaning, such as countermeasure of the deity to whom the Vishwakarman made his dhyana. For this reason, every mantra of Shilpa Sastra is not considered a description or the prescription for the construction of the temple, but as the dhyana mantra going for the dhyana to attaining the Nirvikalpa Samadhi to merge with the God, in which known knower and the knowledge merged and visualized the God. Traditional art is driven by the creativity that combines heavenly inspiration with the ethnic geniusness. Also, tradition is never restricted to expressing the mental visuals. Now it is more important to study the spirit of our ancients through their temple architecture and Vedic studies than to analyze their means of construction. It, just like that of art history, Indian architecture will never be a mere construction. It is an inspiration, prophecy, and revelation of the spirit. Like my ancestor, my consciousness is always fixed with the Vedas and Vedas only, which alone capable of making me their true Vishwakarman to build the temple for the gods. Thank you very much. Dhanyavataha. If any questions, please ask.
Thank you very much, sir. Actually, we are humbled. Such an ecstatic presentation. There are a few questions. I think this question is a little. I think it takes longer for discussion. If time permits, let us take it. Why the erotic sculptures are placed in different temples in India is one question. Is South India, in South India we follow agamas for temple construction. Is it true? If you please explain. Another question by Dharmarajan is, the traditional Vedic scholars and Sthapati community must closely work together to enrich the value of sacred structures. Actually, is it happening? Are the Sthapatis closely involved in the temple construction today, is the question from Dharmarajan. So, the erotic sculptures question, probably Umapati Acharyaji may take a very long time to explain.
I will take little time for explaining it.
Yeah, please.
Don't afraid. Huh? Yeah. Okay. Erotic. I already mentioned the landscape. There is no landscape in our sculpture because we are always thinking tree as well as a god. Like the erotic also, certain marks, we have the Kama Sutra also. It is a part and parcel of our life. That is why in Khajuraho, some other places, only 10% of the sculpture in the category of erotic. So erotic, it is what we all call Bandha in the Sanskrit, and it is a codification also. How the inner walls are joined together, it is a coding for the sculptors for the next generation. If I visited your old temple, we have to notice some of the marks. These marks are giving me the idea how to extend the temple, how to extend the other works. That is why erotic sculptures are there. It is an part and parcel. Vamachara is also with us. Not only that's a Vaidika Puja, we have the Vamachara Puja, especially of the Orissa temples, made out of the yantras, and they are more focused upon the tantri. Next question is agamas. Agamas are there. Agamas, if for example, Vimanarcha Kalpa in the Vaishnava, there are two types, Panjaratha and Vaikanasa. In the all the, almost all the agamas, what says the Sarya Kriya Yoga Jnanapa. In the Kriya Pada, they mentioned it. Only few Saiva agamas explaining the temple architecture. And what it say always, if you have any doubt, you have to refer the Silpa Sastra. In my community, Vishwakarma community, people thrown their text, Silpa Sastra. Why? Because the skill only giving money to them, not the knowledge. That is why they are not read the Silpa Sastra properly. That is why they are agamas pandits are there, the priests are there. They are dependent upon the priest to give their idea. But in according to Saiva Agama, I very clear that you go for Surendranath Banerjee's book to understand the agamas. And agamas, some of the agamas only giving the idea about construction of the temple in very extensively. Rest of the Agamas, very, very brief introduction. If the Vaishnava Agamas, they clearly says that if any doubt arising, just you read the Shilpa Shastra. And another thing is closely associated. I am ready to closely associated with the other people, but our Vishwadharma tradition was systematically sidelined since 1947. I have to accept even the barbarians who were destroyed our temples. In the colonial rule, they are putting the inferiority complex among the scholars as well as that of the Vishwadharma community. But what happened? Only after 1947, my community was systematically sidelined. So I am ready to work with the every people. The architects, modern, I am also taking classes for the architects as well as the design engineers also. So we are ready to cooperate with each and everybody. May I especially request Shefaji Vaidyaji, you have to take note of it, please. We have to extend. We have to extend our cooperation because we have because only few people are available. Wherever the people are coming and asking me, sir, we want to construct a temple of Iposia Kosi. Whether you want to construct a temple or a temple-like structure. If you want to construct a temple, I will be a right person for you. If you want temple-like structure, hundreds of people are there, go there and they were built. That means the understanding of the Shilpa text, the understanding of the Veda and Upanishad, without understanding of the Veda, without understanding of Indian history, it is not at all possible for them.
Sir, this was one of the most mesmerizing talks and presentations that I've ever witnessed. I'm actually feeling emotional. Just give me a moment. It was, what I will always remember is when you said that Indian art is not concerned with the minor reality of senses. It is not even concerned with the major reality of emotions, but it is concerned with the supreme reality of the spirit. These words will be etched in my mind forever. And I think that is the greatest understanding about Indian arts that, I'm sorry, I'm really emotional. Namaste.
Yeah, I am also emotional for hundreds of years, my community. Why 1947? After the 47, my community was vandalized. My community was sidelined. Even within my community, some people do not understand the Shastra properly. They are spread out. What the secret we have? What kind of emotion with me, like Shifaliji? In my family, we have hundreds of Shastra with my hand. I am translating. What is the speciality? Just 1 minute I want to tell you. During the period of the attack, there is no temple construction activity for 100 years in Tamil Nadu. Malikapur and other. The Madurai Meenakshi temple was locked for more than 40 years. But please think about the Vishwakarma community. For no work for 100 years, but after the Vijayanagara Empire, we have constructed a lot of temples in a magnificent size. How it is possible? My father told me thousands of stories. How the Vishwakarma family ladies, women who teach their sons and daughters, not with that of the models, just in the air. My father told me, our great-grandmothers constructed the temple in the air. That is why still in my family tradition, each and every woman, my wife, my child, every woman in my family are well known that of the Sanskrit, well known about that of the Veda mantras. They are all well aware of each and every significant word in the Shilpa Shastra. Myself and my daughter, she is actually a cost accountant. Myself, my daughter, both are working together in the Sanskrit and we are making the glossary for it. That is the tradition. But my father told me one thing. You do our work, your own work, your research, everything you made it, and keep it with my family. Because society may not come and praise you. Don't need the recognition. Just you do the work. That is my father's word. Like we are still working with that of the Shilpa Shastra.
So, this is another revealing aspect, Umapati ji, gender aspect, that your grandmother, your mother, and your daughter, your wife, all these are educated in this. I'm also not getting words.
No.
So much of revealing information from your personal experience. Thank you very much, sir. We have to move on to the next paper. Otherwise, we can have you for the whole conference can go with you. Thank you very much.
Namaste. Dhanyavad.
Thank you very much, sir.
My respects to Shefali ji and Nagaraj also. My humble.
Sir, I'll come to Kumbakonam and spend some time with you at your feet. Thank you so much.